you know what it means to miss New Orleans, where mockingbirds used to sing. I'd like to see the lazy Mississippi a-hurrying in to spring. Oh, the Mardi Gras, the memories of Creole tunes that fill the air. I dream of old Yanders in June, and soon I'm wishing that I was there. Do you know what it means to miss New Orleans, when that's where you left your heart? There's something more, I miss the one I care for more than I miss New Orleans.
Uh-huh. I was just comparing premiums in your wraparound policy.
Wraparound?
Frank, we need
to. I'm coming.
Yeah. And it seems to me that the best way to cut insurance costs would be for you to install a ceiling sprinkler system.
Yeah, what does it cost?
Well, I could find out for you. You know, there's a company that does a bang-up job, and they don't charge you arm and leg. Mr. Parrish.
I'm coming.
And to make things reasonable, I'll have them do the kitchen first. You know, that's the main fire hazard.
Okay, let's do it.
Thank you. Now, you don't have to check with anybody, do you?
No, let's get on.
Let's get on. Rampart Plumbing Electric, do it. I can call them.
Call them.
Okay.
Bubba?
Hold on, Frank.
Not much.
Frank.
Bye. Shorty, what's wrong with Big O?
I told you, he can't find his knife.
Get him another one.
To a chef, his knife's everything. You just don't go get another one.
Oh, now turn up. Ah, Mrs. L'Amour. How are you today?
Oh, I couldn't be happier.
Good.
See that man over there? He wants to talk to you.
Complaint?
Probably.
You wanted to see me?
Oh, Mr. Parrish. I'm Ozone Dreyer. This is James Drayton.
Oh, how are you?
Fine. I just wanted to say hello.
Oh, sit down.
I've been coming in here for years. This is a great place.
Well, thank you.
I really wanted to say hello because I understand that you're from Boston.
Yeah.
I lived up there for 2 years.
Is that right?
It's a good town.
Great town.
When were you there?
Oh, I lived there right after college. I went to Brown, and then I...
Brown?
Yeah. I went to Brown. No!
Class of 71.
67!
I'll be damned.
Oh, that Professor Patterson, English Lit.
Oh, man, was she good looking.
And Gianelli, the Mussolini of the...
Poli-Sci department.
Exactly. Oh, man, we've got it together.
Absolutely.
Help.
Oh, you're busy.
Yeah. But let's do get together.
Well, I'll drop by.
Please do. I'm always here. Okay. Pleasure meeting you both.
Good to see you.
Okay.
Okay, what's going on?
What you so happy about?
I just met a brown man out there.
Well, is that so unusual, Frank?
Oh, yeah. I'm a brown man, too. So, what's going on?
It's Big Arthur. He's giving everybody a hard time, especially me, and I want you to talk to him about it.
I'm sure Big Arthur has his reasons.
It's that damn knife.
It's around here somewhere. It'll show up.
I'm going to kill the man who took it.
What?
I said I'm going to kill the man who took it.
Maybe it wasn't a man.
Hi, Frank.
Hi.
I've got something for you.
Yeah? Where'd you get that?
You left it at the funeral parlor after the reception.
Oh, no, it wasn't me.
Take the knife.
No, not me.
Frank, take the knife. I want to go eat lunch.
All right.
Where'd you get this?
You know that Dr. Hanna's engaged to? He had it. Good idea. You're the company that was recommended by my insurance man, Mr. Holloway?
Sure. He's my uncle. Owns half the business.
It's still a good idea.
Hey! Oh, Frank! Mr. Parrish.
Just Frank. Hosell, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Have a seat.
Thank you. Can I get you a drink?
No, thank you. Listen, I'd like to invite you to lunch tomorrow.
Well, lunch is when we're...
Oh, Frank, you can take a little time off every now and then. Have a little fun.
Well, okay. Where you want to eat?
Well, how about at my club, the Capital C? It's a little stuffy, but it's a good place to make contacts and meet people.
Okay, fine.
And I'd love to have another brown man join me there.
I'd be delighted. Tag, you know where this club is?
I do.
What time?
12:30?
Sure.
And listen, I'd like to invite you to meet some of the members of the club. Is that all right?
Sure.
Okay. All right.
Well, thank you.
I'll see you there.
Bye now. What is the Capital C Club?
It's a men's club. We got a lot of them down here.
Probably wouldn't be a bad idea for me to join one of them. Might be good for business.
I didn't know you were interested in lodge work.
Well, I'm not. It's just that, you know.
Well, you should come to my club.
Oh, well, thank you. I'll do that sometime.
Well, do it tonight. The Reverend Deal is a member.
Oh, well, that speaks for itself.
And we want to thank you, Lord, for bringing Brother Jackson's boy back from the Navy safe and sound.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Where he so nobly served his country in one of them messes we got ourselves into with the Iranians and the other Arabs.
Mm-hmm.
And further, Lord, we ask your blessings on the Congress of the United States, the executive branch, the judicial branch of the government, and all the officials appointed and elected, and all the members of this social club, living and dead. Mm-hmm. In your name, we humbly beseech you. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Reverend,
You're going to have to cut down on these prayers some.
I know it.
Not like we haven't talked about this before.
I'm looking into it.
Well, thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Can we have the reading of the minutes from the last meeting?
Thank you, Brother Grand Driver. At our last meeting, we unanimously agreed to send a $35 flower arrangement to Brother Madison's oldest sister, Lucinda,
mm-hmm.
who was struck by a car, but not seriously.
Oh, good.
Now, a motion was then passed to send the remaining monies in the education fund to Gremlin University.
Yeah.
Now, I sent a check for $56.16 to the university, and they sent it back with a note that said, "What's this for?"
We'll send it back to him with a letter that says, "For education."
What the hell's the matter with dumb people? Any more minutes?
Uh-uh.
Well, I understand we got a guest in the house tonight. Friend of Driver Tigers.
Our guest is Frank Parrish from Boston. Frank is Ennis Parrish's boy. And he's a new owner of the Chez, Louisiana, and a good friend of mine. I mean, of Tigers. He's also a brown man. What in the hell is that supposed to mean?
Well, anyway,
Frank, welcome to the Coachman Social Aid and Pleasure Club.
Make yourself at home. Any old business?
No.
Any new business?
No.
Anybody get hit by a car?
No.
Okay, meeting adjourned. And I'm going to have me a drink.
Hey, if you're not up on your dues, don't drink. Not even water.
Oh, this is a club, my boy. You want a hat?
No, thank you, Tiger. I don't think I have a hat face. What are those big pictures over there?
Oh, this one picture is of Augustus Havens, the first free black carriage driver in the city of New Orleans and the founder of this club.
No kidding.
Been going on since about 1875. There's another brother driver at Mardi Gras.
You guys dress like Indians?
Yeah, man. We something, ain't we?
Come on, Tiger. Quit messing around.
Now we gonna get serious.
You have one?
No.
Well, take it. You sick or something?
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
if I didn't care more than words can say. If I didn't care, would I feel this way? If this isn't love, then why do I thrill? And what makes my head go round and round while my heart stands still? If I didn't care, would it be the same? Would my every prayer begin and end with just your name? And would I be sure that this is love beyond compare? Would all this be true if I didn't care for you? Do I?
Did you know that there are more aspirin sold per person in New Orleans than in any other city in the United States?
I'm not surprised by that.
This stuff is hangover's worst enemy. It's called Mama Yaya.
Do I drink it or soak my feet in it?
Can you drink it real fast without thinking? They're still putting up a sprinkler system.
They must be killed, Tiger.
You're not finished?
All done, all done. And here's your bill.
Holy.
Bad?
No, not really.
See you around. Anything goes wrong, you give us a call.
Right.
You're looking a little puny there, boss.
Yeah, puny. Tiger, I don't think I can go to that guy's club today.
Then don't go.
What club?
The,
Capital C Club.
Ha! Capital C? Now, what would somebody like you be doing in a place like that?
I was invited there. I may even join if they ask me.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Well, let me tell you something.
Honey, Frank is not feeling well, so let him be. Just this once. Frank, take this out to the bar and drink it down. In 1 hour, you'll be perfectly fine.
What's he doing going to that club?
He likes the fellas over there.
I bet he does. But what's he gonna do when they put the bag on him?
I don't think they do that anymore.
The heck they don't. They gonna bag test that boy and send him home for Christmas.
People bag test the only test I ever passed in my whole life.
Well, it was amazing. These guys could pass for the ink spots. I didn't even know Tiger could play the piano.
Tiger?
Oh, a Tiger, yes. He's the bartender at Frank's place. Well, anyway, the Coachman Club was a lot of fun.
Oh, the Young Men's Illinois would be a far better club than that one.
Well, this one is certainly beautiful.
The Young Men's Illinois Club was originally started by New Orleans porters working for the Illinois Railroad. But it's an excellent club.
Well, certainly passable. Do you want another drink? What is that?
Ginger ale.
You don't drink?
Well.
He's probably got bad kidneys.
Mr. Broussard's grandfather was one of the original founders of the Capital C Club.
That was in 1895. You know, my grandfather was a physician. French Quarter Creole. Later we moved over to Claiborne. So it's French and Spanish Creole.
That's fascinating.
Yes, the cream of the crop. Not like a mix.
Mix?
A Negro mix.
Frank went to Brown. We worked there together, but we just missed each other.
And you lived in Boston?
Yes.
Prep school?
Middlesex, on a scholarship.
Oh. That's not bad.
You knew my father?
I knew of him.
Ah, uh-huh. Frank was an associate professor before he took over his father's enterprise.
Oh, and you taught what?
Italian Renaissance history.
Oh, lei parla italiano. I mean, you speak Italian.
I read it.
Tell me, Frank, how do you find the restaurant business?
Well, I don't think a person can jump right into it. On the other hand, common sense alone can tell an educated person some of the things that need doing. I've instigated a program of improvements at the Chez. That's Chez Louisiane. And it seems to be working quite well indeed.
It's important that all our fine young ladies be properly introduced into society. They have to have social grace and charm. Now, all of our debutantes and queens are carefully chosen and trained.
Sure. Do you dress as Indians at Mardi Gras?
We don't believe in costumes. All of our members are required to wear tails, top hats, white gloves, and white ties. It's a tradition here in the club.
But it's not all socializing, Frank. Look, last year, we raised nearly $20,000 for sickle cell. And every year, we donate heavily to Xavier and Dillard.
Well, you know, it's nice to have met you, Frank. A man would be lucky to get into this club. Very, very lucky indeed.
I bet.
I enjoyed our little talk.
The feeling I've just been examined.
Oh, you were.
I also get the feeling I'm being watched.
You are. I'd like to put your name up for nomination, Frank. What do you think?
Well, I'd be honored.
That's great.
Do you know a Dr. Lamar Boysenberry?
Yeah. He's engaged to Hannah Griffin.
Is he a member of this club?
Oh, no.
Good. I like this club. Falling on
my head. Yes? A fire! We had a fire?
Boy, I was smart to install those sprinklers. They went off by themselves.
They put a heat detector over the fryers.
Well, I'm sorry, guys. I really am. Let me help you clean up around here.
We got it, Frankie.
Yeah. I probably should just stay out of the way.
Yeah, I guess you should. We don't need no sprinklers in here. He shouldn't be off gallivanting with a bunch of snobs who are laughing at him behind his back because he's colored. He ought to be just here letting us...
I'm colored? What do you mean I'm colored? I haven't heard that word in 20 years.
It's nothing, Frank.
No, I want to know.
See this bag?
Yeah.
Which is darker, me or the bag?
You.
Which is darker, you or the bag?
What are you talking about?
The Capital C Club. In the old days, Frank, if you were a light-skinned black, you were a Creole. And they spell Creole with a capital C. If you were dark-skinned, it was Creole with a little C. And there was a big difference between the two.
Skin color used to be the big separator in New Orleans, Frank.
Still is. They just ain't as out in the open about it.
Why would Ozell Dry have me there?
Yo.
Hey, Frank. Well, hey, you know, we could have met at the club. I could have made
No, I wanted to talk to you somewhere else.
Oh, okay.
Ozell, I'm not going back in that club again.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Why would you do that to me, man? I mean, I know we just met, but...
Wait, hold on. Give me a chance here, Frank.
I'll tell you something. I'm really embarrassed. You know that?
Well, you shouldn't be. You were just my guest.
That's all, just your guest.
Well, no, you were there as potential member.
Yeah, well, let me go get one of those brown bags.
No. Please.
Or could we talk Negro mix? How about that?
No, that is Broussard. He's an old fool. But unfortunately, he's an important old fool.
Not to me.
Well, fine.
So what was I going to be, the first darky in the Capital C Club?
Oh, man, look, I am sorry. I should have been more upfront with you about this, but there's a group of us in the club that are trying to change things.
And I'm the guinea pig?
Well, sort of. See, you've got all the credentials to put an end to this whole color thing. You're...
Ozell, let me cut to the chase here, okay? All my life, I've been, quote, the only black. I was the only black in this class. I was the only black in that organization. I was the only black on this team. Look, man, I'm not about to become the only black in a black club. I think that's going a little too far, don't you think?
Yeah, I guess so. If you ever change your mind.
Frank, the grand driver just dropped by with something for you.
It's yours if you want it. Cost you $25 to join. Go get it then.
Welcome, brother. You're gonna love Mardi Gras, brother driver.